it's Kimberly with the Fat Quarter Shop, and we are at the 2014 Spring International Quilt Market, and we're in Bonnie Sullivan's booth from All Through the Night. And I'm sure all of you know how popular Birdie's Year Block of the Month was that started in 2014, and she's back with another Block of the Month. This one's called Birdie's Winter Block of the Month, and it's really small. Tell me what size this is.
It's 28 by 34, and it's a four-month Block of the Month program.
And so she's got four patterns, so tell me about the different patterns you have.
Okay, well, there's each pattern gives you one block of the finished product. The last pattern gives you two blocks. But in case you didn't want to make this, it also gives you an option to make something else with the block. So this one tells you how to make it into a penny rug. There's a table runner, a pillow, and a frame picture and a journal cover.
And each of the patterns shows you how you can take this and finish it. And when you buy this Block of the Month at the Fat Quarter Shop, it begins in July 2014. It's a four-month program. And the wonderful thing about this Block of the Month, tell me about the fabric you use. Mm-hmm. What are you using?
These are the Woolies flannels that I designed for Maywood Studio. And it's a really nice heavyweight flannel. And all the pieces actually have been fused on. I used Shades Soft Fuse. I really love it. It doesn't gum up your needle. It's really pliable. And once everything is fused in place, I just whip stitch around it with regular thread, embroidery floss, whatever you want to use there. So it's a really great take-along project and easy to finish.
Yeah. And so you do hand applique, but you could also use machine. Mm-hmm. And also, this fabric is great because it looks like wool, but it's flannel, so it's a lot easier to sew with. And then you've also got these three embellishments that we offer as an embellishment kit at the Fat Quarter Shop. So tell me what you use each of these items for.
Sure. This little bead pack, on things like the snow globe, you have little beads to look like the settling snow. Or over here, there's a sugar cookie, and you use the little clear ones to look like crystals on the sugar cookie. All the holly berries are red buttons. Down at the bottom one, there's an earmuff that's made out of a button, or he's got a little button closure here. So the button pack contains all of that. And there's a thread pack from Presentia that has all the different colors of the embellishment threads you'll need, like for his legs or the vines on the holly leaves.
And do you put your buttons and embellishments on when you're piecing or at the end?
Well, true confession is, I was too curious to see what it would look like when I sewed each block, so I went ahead and embellished it and got it all ready, and then I sewed the piece together, and when I went to do a little bit of quilting on it, it made it a little difficult. So in the directions, I do say, although you may want to finish the embellishment now, you might want to wait until you've got it all put together.
Well, we hope you enjoy this Block of the Month. It's super quick and easy because it's so small. It'll make a great wall hanging in your home, and it's just super adorable. So thank you so much,
Bonnie. Thanks.